people hear the word contractors, they often think mercenaries. That's not really the case. Contractor is someone paid by the government to work in a supporting role in a combat zone. This could be a cook, a generator mechanic, or a gate guard. Now, the changing face of warfare in the last decade has called for a different kind of person. Someone with a unique skill set, often from the special operations community, that can work in jobs and complete missions that the U.S. military really doesn't have the time or the manpower to complete. Since 9/11, we have been fighting on asymmetric battlefields. That means there is no front. That also means there's no safe place at all. Someone coming visiting into that area, a dignitary, a high-ranking officer, maybe even a performer in a USO show, they have to be protected. Most of these missions are defensive, but it's safe to say there are some that are offensive. Either way, if you want to succeed and survive doing this job, you better be good at CQB. When a team of private contractors are operating in a foreign battle zone, they're most often without the support of a larger military infrastructure. This has some advantages, as decisions can be made without the usual bureaucracy of larger militaries, but at the same time, it comes with its own set of problems and challenges. Private military contractor teams are often made up of ex-special forces operators from the international community. In the case of Iraq and Afghanistan, several international contracting companies were involved from the beginning of the conflicts in all aspects of operations, even in forward fighting roles. When operating as a PMC unit, you're often unsupported in the traditional military sense. So if something goes wrong, there is often no command structure or rescue force that can support you. Often, contractor teams in Iraq and Afghanistan worked in unmarked bulletproof vehicles where they had a specific high-value target that they needed to capture and turn over to the military or intelligence department. When traveling through the streets of a war zone, there is the potential for danger around every corner. In a contracting team, you have to have skilled dynamic drivers, weapons demolition and medical specialists, and everybody must be a skilled shooter. The principles of surprise, speed, and violence of action are used by PMC operators. They have to use speed as they travel and as they prepare to move in on a target. They have to maintain the element of surprise with a good route selection during the approach in order to catch the target unprepared for their arrival. They have to use intense but controlled violence of action as they overwhelm the target so they can keep the team members alive and be victorious in the fight. Now let's take a look at the futuristic-looking personal defense weapon, the FN-P90. The P90 was originally developed in the late 80s by the Belgian company Fabrique Nationale as a personal defense weapon.
But tell us about this one. That's unusual.
This is a FN-P90 submachine gun.
P90, okay.
With a bullpup system.
Most systems, the magazine is in front of the whole trigger assembly. The bullpup is actually, that's behind it, okay?
Yes, exactly. As you say, the chamber is at the back of the weapon.
Right.
So we have long barrel with
yeah.
our weapon.
Right, right.
In this type, the magazine is on the top.
Yeah, that's unusual, man. It's really unusual. It's an interesting magazine.
And it has a big capacity with 50 rounds.
50-round mag?
Yeah, 50-round mag.
What's the caliber of that? This is 9mm? What is that?
Yeah, this is a caliber 5.7.
So, more damage, bigger bullet?
Yeah, the bullet is a little lighter with high velocity.
Yeah.
And good penetration.
Yeah, that's basically, that's an assault rifle. It's pretty much an assault rifle, but you know what's great about that? I mean, that's so darn short because of the way it's configured with the magazine in the back.
Short.
Yeah, I actually look forward to firing it. I've never fired anything like that. That's cool. Can I try it?
Sure.
Yeah, Kui. I'm a lefty, so it's a little different. Yeah. It's so small, man. I mean,
it's very small.
Yeah, I can't wait to fire this thing. It's a nice little sight on there too, actually.
Yeah.
The idea was to create a compact weapon that could fire in fully automatic mode and carry a high-capacity magazine. NATO was requesting that companies develop a weapon using the 5.7 by 28 millimeter ammunition. The P90 has a unique bullpup design that features a top-loading 50-round magazine. I like it because as a left-handed shooter, the P90's ambidextrous design allows me to shoot without the shell casings flying right by my face. Sometimes it's the little things.